Good morning. Today is going to be a market day. It is Sunday. By the time that you are seeing this, it's probably Wednesday. So I had always planned to go to the Kirribilli Markets this weekend, and this weekend it falls on a Sunday. The Kirribilli Markets is a weekly market for craft people, like makers, and also secondhand stuff. So I usually go to the secondhand area, but there's also food stalls there. And it alternates between Saturdays and Sundays. So this week it is on a Sunday, and it's art, design, and general and fashion market this week. So I'm going to that one. And yeah, but I also just found out through my Facebook alerts that it is also the Sydney suitcase rummage is also happening today, which is normally on the last Sunday of every month, but for some reason it's happening today. So I'm gonna go for that. But before that, I wanted to do an OOTD for today. So for my shirt, this is, I think it's 2 years old. It's from Esprit Decor, and it is 100% organic cotton. Jeans are thrifted. These are Armani jeans, men's jeans that I distressed myself. I got it from the Mustard Seed op shop, and it was for $6, so pretty chuffed with that. Shoes you would have seen me thrift yesterday at Nuff's op shops. This is by Winsor Smith, and it was $5. Earrings were also thrifted from Nuff's op shop yesterday. They were $3. Bracelet is from Vinnie's in Randwick. It was $4. And then the usual engagement ring, wedding ring, my Fitbit Versa. And I am going out with a statement bag. This is the Fendi black Napa leather. What is it called? Spy bag, which was discontinued in 2012. And I've got there a thrifted silk scarf from Salvos in, what do you call this? This is in Salvos in Minchinbury. Okay, it was $1. This Fendi, it was $29 from U-Turn Vintage. And you would have seen already in the video that came out yesterday, or actually, it's coming out today, Sunday. That I'm not actually sure if this is a replica or if it is genuine. The only difference with the genuine one and this is that this doesn't have a hologram tag, but apparently, bags that were made prior to 2015 don't have the hologram tags. So I like to believe it's real, but even if it isn't, $29 for this beautiful leather bag is not a bad deal. Okay, and you would probably notice in the background that it's pretty messy in this room because I am packing for Manila. I'm going home for the holidays. I'm gonna be away for 12 days. So this is actually, I'm actually planning to do a 12 by 12, which is a variation of the 10 by 10. Sort of like capsule wardrobe thing that is all over YouTube, and I'm trying to decide what outfits I am going to use or I'm going to bring with me. Now, this side of my luggage are actually things that I am going to give away to my family and some friends. This is the giveaway prize that I am giving to one of my Filipino subscribers. This bag here, if you remember, I painted over this. This was a Murakami Louis Vuitton dupe. And inside there is a bunch of makeup that I wanted to give him because he is a budding YouTuber who is into makeup. And this Furla bag here is being sold to a friend of mine. The Calvin Klein bag is for my mom. And the two Lacoste shoes are going to my sisters-in-law. Okay, so it is only actually this side that is going to have my clothes in. I already got a Uniqlo dress here that I've had for 2 years. This is another Uniqlo romper. So that's already one outfit. This one I got from the Glebe Markets. I haven't actually worn this, so this is going to be a first time. That's already one outfit. So three outfits. And then I'm debating on this because this would require a t-shirt underneath it. But I think because I'm bringing jeans anyway, so I'm actually bringing this pair of jeans with me, the one that I'm wearing right now, and another pair. So that'll be five items already. And the plus this is six items. And then it would include shoes. I'm bringing my Birkenstock and my Converse. So that'll be eight. So I'll need four t-shirts to rotate during the time that I'm there. I'm not going to be including in the count swimsuits because that's not technically an outfit that I would wear out. But because the family is staying over at a resort, I'm going to have to bring a swimsuit. And I'm thinking if I will, and I'm also not counting pajamas or sleepwear, again, because I'm not actually going to be wearing that outside. It's just for me to sleep in. So once I've decided on the outfits, I am going to do a video of my 12 by 12. And then we'll go from there. I think that's it for the introduction, which is quite long. yep, that's another look at the outfit. I'm going to go now. And what I am trying to find in the markets today are gifts for my brothers, because that was a fail yesterday. With the exception of that Billabong shorts, which might go to Duncan instead of my brothers, I haven't actually found anything for my brothers. All of my sisters-in-law and my mom are already covered, as you would have seen in that bag, but my brothers don't have anything yet. So they are on my list of to buys today. And I've got $65 in cash in my wallet. Gonna try to stick to that budget. I'll tell you if I fail or if I pass. Okay, bye. So this shop at the corner has got everything for $10, and I got my brother's gifts in there. So the guy who was at Surrey Hills Market yesterday is also here. And he's selling those replica bags again. Okay, so I'm walking over to the Sydney suitcase rummage. And because it's going to take me longer if I wait for the bus. So I'm walking over there. I decided to leave my big bag behind. And I just have a reusable bag in my pocket with my phone and my house keys. Because it's pretty near where I lived. I was just being lazy earlier. But yeah, we've been there before. I've shown you that place before. And the reason I decided not to bring much with me is because I don't want to buy anything anymore. Okay, so here we are again at the goods line, where you've got the secondhand pre-loved market. I did stall here once before. It was the worst day ever. I think I made like $25 at 4 hours. So I didn't do it again. I was like under the sun. It was hot. I was dehydrated. I was getting a migraine. But anyway, we're here and we're going to have a look at what's available. So that was a pretty quick visit. I think I spent like less than 10 minutes and $10 in there because I unexpectedly found something that I have been looking for in the thrift shops. For $10. So now I'm gonna head home and show you what I got today. Okay, so let me show you guys what I got in today's shopping expedition when I went to Kirribilli Markets and the Sydney suitcase rummage. So let's start with the Kirribilli Markets. Now, as I've said in the beginning of this video, I'm looking for gifts for my brother since I've already covered all the female in my family. But my siblings, my actual brothers, haven't got anything from me yet. So as I went through the Kirribilli Markets, there was a shop called, well, it just had a sign that says everything $10. So I went in and they had a rack for men. And my siblings are about the same size as me, okay, in terms of like the width. So they're mostly like a medium in European or Australian sizes. Some of them probably are large in Filipino size or in Asian size. The first thing that I found is this t-shirt. This is by Esprit. Okay, so it's a nice enough t-shirt. And it is made in Bangladesh. It's a medium. And does it say lived in and loved, laundered garments, old favorite, tumbled and lived in. Pay attention to details, it says. So it's got a really nice material. And I'm just going to double check what it is made of. 100% cotton. Okay. 100% cotton made in Bangladesh. So now, two of my brothers work from home like I do, and the other one works in office. So one of the ones who are working from home will get this Esprit shirt. The other one working from home will receive this this t-shirt that says Living the Dream. I think it'll be my eldest brother because this has a bicycle on it and he cycles. So, and this is, they remove the tag here, but it is 100% cotton, made in, designed and printed in Australia, made in Bangladesh. So the t-shirt itself is made in Bangladesh. Cold wash with light colors, do not soak, do not tumble dry, warm iron on reverse side of print, do not dry clean. Cycling is our medium of storytelling, fashion is our heritage. So it's got this little tag on here, Après Velo. I don't know if that's how you say it. Live the ride. Land of the devoted, home of the insane. Okay, yeah, so this is gonna go to my eldest brother, who also loves to cycle and works from home. And then my middle brother, I've got three brothers, works in an office. So I found this linen blend from the Prodigy collection. And it's this blue with white vertical stripes, and it's got a little pocket. And like I said, it's a linen blend, just to confirm that. It's got this extra buttons on the tag. It says cotton and linen. Cold machine wash, do not bleach, do not dry clean, wash inside out, do not tumble dry. It's made in China. Yep, so it's got those two spare buttons there. But it's in really good condition. They're all in medium size because my siblings are all the same sizes. So I'm pretty sure this would fit. Hopefully. Okay, so those are the gifts for my siblings. Wait. I almost forgot. There's one other thing that I bought for $10 as well at the Kirribilli Market. And it is this beautiful bangle that I am wearing right now. Okay. It's got that like, sort of like a pearly shell white thing inside. And it's got also like three little gems on there. And I love the gold detail. This particular one says that it is Cartier 750. As to whether this is a real Cartier or not, I don't know. I'm sure they wouldn't have sold it for only $10 if it was a real Cartier. But I am happy to have bought it for only $10. Now, this one is something that I was considering to resell, but have now decided to keep for myself. This is the kind of item, or this is the kind of brand, that when you know, you know. Okay. I stumbled upon this. This is a Loewe leather bag. It's called Bagno Palladio, I think. It's essentially this really understated leather, pebbled leather bag. It's got Loewe on the hardwares, like so. The zips are of leather. It's got Loewe there on the front, very, very understated. That is the only indication outside that this is a Loewe bag. It doesn't have that heat stamp that the puzzle bag has or the gate bag has. So, like, I didn't even notice it until I looked closely. But I got this. There was in the Kirribilli Market, almost at the entrance of where the secondhand stuff are, was an old lady and her husband. They are, based from the accent, I think they are originally French. So I was looking at this particular bag. I just want to tell you the story, okay? This is to justify why I bought it. So I was looking at this particular bag, and that's when I noticed the label. Because it didn't seem like anything spectacular. I just noticed it because the leather was really nice. It's still quite stiff. Doesn't feel like it's been used quite a lot. And looking at the whole bag, there isn't any kind of like wear and tear on the bag. So I looked closer. It was a Loewe bag. And I asked her how much she was selling for it. And then she looked at me and then she winked and said, "This is a bag that if you know, you know." And then she winked. And I was like, "I think I know what you mean." So when I looked inside, I found, so it only had, let me just take this out. Take the lining out so you can see. So it only had that Loewe leather over there, okay? And then the lining also says Loewe. So it wasn't anything similar to what I have seen before. I mean, I know that the newer Loewe bags are have sort of like a linen texture almost in the inside. And they would have the tag that says underneath the brand Loewe that says made in Spain. And I really couldn't find that in this bag. The only indication that would tell me that this was a legitimate and a real bag is this card here. But we all know that replicas nowadays come with these things. So it had this little card inside. And so I looked and I looked and I looked until I was like, you know what? I'm just going to buy it. And I asked her how much she was selling it for. She said to me, $50. And I was like, that made me think that this is probably a replica. And then she tells me it's originally $1,250, but she was just selling it for $50 because she wanted to get rid of it. And when I got home, I did a thorough inspection of the bag and found this little section in the inside pocket. So I'm just going to take that lining again. Okay. And if I hadn't done this, like turn it inside out, I would never have found it. But this one here, there's an inside pocket, and inside that pocket is that little tag that has the serial number and where it says made in Spain. Okay, so I was pretty chuffed to find that. Guess I had already given up the idea that this might be a real Loewe bag, but it turns out that it is. And that booth that they had was actually like a long table full of memorabilia, like all of the stuff that they've collected throughout the years. Because she and her husband, and when I say old lady, I mean she's like past 70. And it's almost like they're like trying to get rid of the stuff that they don't want anymore, and like selling it for cheap just to get rid of it. They seem like a really happy couple too. So I didn't feel bad about letting go of $50, even though I wasn't sure that it was real. But I am especially happy to find out that it is real. Now, you would have seen me also go to the Sydney suitcase rummage. There wasn't really a lot that I was interested in because, I mean, honestly, I don't need to be looking at bags anymore. oh, and by the way, before I move on to that, since I decided to keep this for myself, that means that I have to go through my collection and decide which one I'm going to let go of. So I'm actually going to set aside a few bags that I'm going to resell from my thrifting adventures and really just keep the ones that I really like. Okay. Now at the Sydney suitcase rummage, I was passing by and this little thing caught my eye. You know how square toes are the in thing this year? Well, I found these pair of boots. Not only do they have a square toe, but they also have squared off heels. So I was like, oh wow, that's cute. So I approached, but I wasn't sure because it looked quite small. And this has the sizing 230 or 230, which is like the Japanese sizing. For this would have been equivalent to a 36.5 or a 6. And I'm usually a 37, so I was a little afraid that this was going to be too small, but decided to try it on just the same. And because it's pre-loved and real leather, this is real Italian leather, and it actually says so at the back. It's real Italian leather, and it has already stretched from use by the original owner. And so it actually fit my 37 foot. Okay. The leather itself doesn't even have any scuffing. The only indication that it has been used is some heel damage there. Okay, and there. Like it's all in the heel. Yep, and it's really soft leather. And I love the chocolate brown look. And the inside is also beautiful and soft. So quite happy with this. And I'm even happier to tell you that this only cost me $10. I have been looking for brown boots, specifically square toe boots. And that just came really handy. And I'm also quite happy that it's only about 1.5 inches of heel height there, which means that I could actually walk in it. Although, I would probably have to use really thin socks or tights on these because any thicker sock would make it impossible for me to wear them. But yeah, that's it. That's what I got today from the Kirribilli Markets and Hills, the Sydney suitcase rummage. I hope you guys have a lovely day and I will see you all again in the next video. Bye.